day. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to your name, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory. Glory. Glory.
Hallelujah.
We give you the praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God, hallelujah. God, you're so worthy to be praised. Glory to
yes.
Mothers, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord, saints. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. He's worthy to be praised. The joy of the Lord is my strength. I have a scripture to read, and I will also pray. Yes, if you cry out for discernment and lift up your voice for understanding, if you seek her as silver and search for her as for hidden treasures, then you will understand the fear of the Lord and find the knowledge of God. Praise God for that scripture. I needed it this morning. I've been needing it all weekend since Friday. I praise the Lord for my church family. I praise the Lord for his mercy and grace. I praise the Lord that my son and my grandson appear to be doing fine. They don't have any symptoms. It appears to the doctor that maybe they went through the worst of it thinking they had the flu. So I praise God for that. You know, God is merciful and kind. So I just thank God this morning. I thank him for all that he's doing in our lives today. I thank God for Deacon Burnett. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, for the man of God. I just thank God for him. I thank God for his steadfast and unmovable spirit in God, you know, and his wife right by his side. But I really, really thank God for him. He's an inspiration to us all. He's an inspiration to me, and he should be to us all. So I thank God this morning. Lord, I thank you today for life. I thank you for life abundantly, Lord. I thank you for life in you, Lord. I thank you for the life that you've given us, Lord. I thank you for the life that you gave us that we didn't even deserve, Lord. I thank you, Lord, for life, 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 health, and strength, Lord. I thank you for waking us up this morning in our right mind, Lord. I thank you that we didn't get any bad news, Lord. I thank you that you woke us up, Lord. You put on our clothes, you dressed us, you gave us food to eat, Lord. You gave us water to drink. You gave us coffee, tea, or whatever it was that we desired, Lord. You gave it to us, Lord. You gave us the ability to hear, to see, to touch, to feel. Oh, Lord, to taste all those things, Lord, that we take for granted. Father God, I thank you for those things. I thank you for them, Lord. I thank you for your love. Thank you that your love is so great for us, Lord, that they're new every day. Your mercies are new for us, Lord. Every single day you forgive us over and over and over again. Your mercies are new every day, Lord. We get a chance every single day to get it right. Lord, we got a chance, Lord. Oh, my God. I thank you for letting us be aware of the things around us, Lord, that we must be aware, Lord, that you give us discernment, as the scripture said, that we need to be aware of our surroundings, that we need to be careful in all things and prayerful in all things, Lord, that we don't need to take for granted when we go out, Lord, that it's going to be okay. Lord, we need to be aware and prayerful, anointed and blessed by you. We need to put the armor of God on daily. We need to do it, Lord. We need to think about it before we leave our houses, Lord. I thank you, Lord, that we'll leave and we'll anoint ourselves. We'll anoint our cars, the wheels, the everything, Lord. Bless us today, Lord. I thank you for accepting us as we are, Lord. I thank you for the acceptance that you give us, Lord, that you don't just require us to be anything but faithful service. All you require for us is to repent and say the sinner's prayer, Lord. It's so simple, and we complicate it so much, Lord. I thank you today for that, Lord. I thank you for forgiveness today, Lord. I thank you for forgiving us, Lord, of our sins. I thank you for, Lord, giving us a chance to make amends and then to come back, Lord. And thank you for allowing us to make amends, Lord. Thank you for the people that forgive us of our aughts, Lord. Thank you for the brothers and sisters of Christ that just know, Lord, that we make mistakes. We all make mistakes, Lord. I thank you for forgiveness today, though, Lord. I thank you for forgiveness, for it had not been for you forgiving me, Lord, where would I be, Lord? I thank you for a better understanding of your word. Open the eyes of our understanding to your word, Lord, and your way, Lord, that we will do exactly what you want us to do, Lord, and how you want us to do it, Lord. We'll trust in you, Lord. We'll wait on your spirit to tell us, Lord, what to do, not our own, but your spirit, Lord. I thank you today, Lord. I thank you that I'm trustworthy today, Lord. I thank you for integrity today, Lord. I thank you that we have integrity, Lord, that when we say something, Lord, we're going to do it. And Lord, you're going to make sure that it happens, Lord. So I'm thanking you for integrity today. It's a strong word and it's a strong thing to do, Lord, but I thank you for integrity today. I thank you that we are all in service for you, Lord, that everybody on this line is doing something to further your kingdom, Lord. Oh, what a blessing, what a blessing, what a blessing, Lord. We are so honored and privileged to be your children, Lord. Thank you for allowing us that place in your life, Lord. You didn't have to do it. You didn't have to send your son to suffer a vicious, horrible death for somebody like us that wouldn't even do it for our own kids, Lord. We probably wouldn't want to suffer like that, Lord, if we were given the opportunity. Lord, I thank you for that perfect peace that I have today, the perfect peace that I wish for each and every one on this prayer line, Lord. That peace that passes all understanding in Christ Jesus. Lord, I thank you for peace today. I thank you that you give us peace, Lord, that you allow us to be anointed in peace, Lord. I thank you for the service yesterday. I thank you for the service today. I thank you for being a servant of yours, Lord. I thank you for being the servant that you call to do what everything in righteousness for you, Lord. I just thank you, Lord, today. You are worthy, worthy, worthy God. We don't deserve half of the things that you give us, Lord, but thank you, Lord, for being so generous and so, so kind and loving. So merciful, Lord. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Father God, for you're worthy, worthy, worthy of all the praise in the world. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, I thank you for the ministry, Lord. I thank you for the prayer ministry, Lord. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Lord, for the faithful few, Lord. Oh, my God, that's all it takes is one or more, Lord. We don't even need anybody else on the line but one person, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. I bless your holy name on high today, Lord. I thank you, Lord. I thank you for looking down on each and every one in the church, Lord. I thank you for looking down on the mothers. I thank you for looking down on the brothers, the deacons, the deaconess, Lord, the elders, the ministers, the missionaries. Lord, each and every member of Solid Rock that has a desire or a prayer before you, Lord, I just thank you for letting it happen, Lord. I just thank you for granting them the desires of their heart, Lord, that they serve you in spirit and truth, Lord, and we know what we're going to give for that, Lord. We thanking you this morning, Lord. I thank you for looking down on Lorenzo Young, Lord, and his daughter Tammy. I thank you, Lord, that you could lift him up and carry him through that COVID infection, Lord. I thank you, Lord, that the people that are caring for him in the right way, Lord. I thank you, Lord, that they're touching and agreeing, Lord, and I thank you that no weapon formed against him shall prosper, Lord. Oh, I thank you for Tammy being the faithful daughter that she is, that she probably right there by her father's side or nearby, Lord. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord, for looking down on Jesse this morning, Lord. Look down on little Jesse, Sister Sharon Boy's granddaughter, Lord. Let that temperature go down, Lord. Let it go down, Lord. Let it go down, Lord. Let it go down, Lord. Don't let it go up any higher, Lord. Oh, let that temperature break, Lord, and let her be healed by your stripes, Lord, in the name of Jesus, Lord. I know you're able to do anything but fail, Lord. We trusting in you, Lord, to take care of that child, Lord. She's a child of yours, and her mother's and her grandma's a child of yours, Lord. Oh, my God, we're all your children, Lord. We just know that you'll take care of her, Lord. Take care of her, Lord, and bless her in a special way. Oh, open the eyes of her understanding, Lord. Oh, just bless that young lady, Lord. Look down on Annie, Sybil's mom, and look down on Sybil that she's able to take care of her mother, able to be there in spite of things, Lord, that have happened and gone on with Sister Sybil, and that she's healthy enough to be there for her mom, that she knows to call the doctors and take and make sure that she take notes and understand that she needs to tell them the things that are wrong, when they're wrong and how they're wrong, Lord. I thank you for her, Lord. I thank you, thank you, thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord, for looking down on Keith Gray's family in Texas, Lord. bless them in a special way, Lord. That was a loss, I'm sure, that was a great loss to that family, Lord. And I know you're able to soothe hurting hearts and broken spirits, Lord. You're able to do anything but fail, Father God. I know you won't fail us in any way, shape, form, or fashion, Lord. I thank you, Lord. I thank you, thank you, thank you for looking down on Mother Henry's husband, Jesse. Oh, bless him in a special way. Bless Mother Henry, a faithful woman of God, Lord. You know she wants her husband to be well, Lord. Oh, grant her desires of her heart, Lord. Grant her the desires of her heart that he may come home. Lord, and that he may come home better than he was when he left, Lord. Oh, my God, it's your will be done, not ours. Lord, I'm asking for your will to be done in that situation, Lord. Oh, God, oh, God, oh, God. You are merciful and kind, God. You never leave us nor forsake us, Lord. You are a blessing, Lord. Oh, Lord, what would we do without you? I'm asking you to look down on the homeless today, Lord. Take care of them, Lord. Oh, God, take care of them, Lord. Take care of them. Take care of them. Lord, they don't know which way to go, Lord. Some of them are out there just wondering, Lord. Oh, my God, look down on Miss Betty out there. Oh, God, give her her mind back, Lord, a school teacher, Lord. Out there wandering in the wilderness, Lord, on drugs, Lord. Bless that lady, Lord. Bless her that she may come back to you, Lord. Bless her children who come out there begging her to come back home. Oh, Father God, look down on her. She's been out there for years, Lord. Oh, bless her, bless her, bless her, Lord. You're able. You're able, Father God. Look down on her. Look down on Freddie out there, Lord. Look down on Freddie, Lord, and bless him. Bless him to come up out of there, Lord. He was raised in church. Hallelujah. Bring him back, Lord. He's your child. Bring him back, Lord. Look down in the hospital, Lord. They said that they got more people going into the hospital now, Lord. Oh, God. Oh, just thank you, Lord, for my son and my grandson, Lord. Thank you, Lord, that they're not in the hospital. Thank you, Lord, that even though they have the virus, thank you, Lord, they have no symptoms, Lord. Thank you, Lord, that they can eat, sleep, and wake up, Lord. Thank you, Lord, that the worst has passed, Lord. Thank you, Lord, that you are God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Lord. Oh, my God, thank you for taking care of them, Lord. Thank you for taking care of my family, Lord. Thank you for taking care of each and every one of our family, Lord. I thank you for the blessings that you have for us today, Lord. I thank you for looking down on Sister Beverly, Lord. I rebuked the devil and him messing with her phone. It was happening last week, Lord. Let her just bless her, Lord. Bless her, bless her, bless her, Lord. Look down on Missionary Edmondson, Lord. Touch her in a special way, Lord. Working over there with the elderly, Lord, in those hospitals, Lord. Taking a risk every day with her life, Lord. Oh, just bless her. Bless Sister Tanisha. Bless her, bless her, bless her, Lord. Oh, Lord, she's growing stronger in you, Lord. Just keep your hands on her, Lord. Let her take her hands off of anything that's not like you. Remove it from her life today, Lord. Look down on Sister Bridget and those children, Lord. Oh, my God, watch over them. Watch over them. They only have her, Lord. Bless them in a special way. She only has them, Lord. Oh, bless them, Lord. Bless them, bless them, bless them. Look down on Mother Henry. Look down on Mother Carpenter. Faithful women of God, Lord, that serve you in spirit and truth, Lord. Oh, just bless them, Lord. Bless them in a special way. Look down on Missionary Brooks, Lord. Touch her. Oh, my God, a prayer warrior and just a prayer warrior for you, Lord. Look down on her, Lord. Look down on Sister Bonnie Prowser. Family, Lord, as they go to funeralize her this week, Lord. Look down on them, Lord. Touch them. Touch all five of those children, Lord. Look down on her twin sons, Lord, Clarence and Terrence. Look down on her daughter, Tasha, Lord. Look down on each and every one of her children, Lord. Look down on her husband, Willie, Lord. Look down on them, Lord, and bless them to be able to make it through, Lord. I rebuke the spirit of suicide, Lord. I rebuke it in the name of Jesus. You are lying. You got to get away from here. Oh, my God. I rebuke the spirit of depression, Lord. I rebuke it in the name of Jesus. I thank you for going to the hospitals and watching over each and every one that works there, from the cafeteria staff to the kitchen staff to the CNAs to the RNs to the LVNs, Lord, to the LCSWs, Lord, to the doctors, to the anesthesiologists, to everybody that works in the hospital, Lord. Oh, my God, the psychiatrists, the people in ICU, the babies in the NICU, Lord. Oh, look down over them and their parents, Lord, right now in the name of Jesus. There's a baby that's not going to make it, Lord. But look down on them anyway, Lord. Look down on the families, Lord. Oh, Father God, it's so much that you need, we need from you, Lord. But let us be the servants that you called us to be, Lord. Because we praying from our hearts. Let us be ministers of your word, Lord. Let us get out of the church and into the streets, Lord. And everywhere we go, somebody will know that we belong to you, Lord. Let our walk and our talk reflect who we are in you, Lord. Let us get out, Lord, and do some good today, Lord. Each and every one of us that are able, Lord. Let us get out and help somebody today, Lord. Help somebody, Lord. Oh, in the name of Jesus, let us help somebody today. If it's nothing but feed somebody, Lord, or pray for somebody, or just tell them, can I pray for you for a moment? Oh, my God. Oh, God, help us, Lord. Lord, we so far gone, we can't turn around sometime, Lord, but you know all about it, Lord. I just thank you, Lord, that you don't judge us as our sins deserve. And Lord, I'm thanking you today for everything, each and everything you're about to do in our lives today. Lord, remove the taste of alcohol from those that have the taste of alcohol in their mouth. Drugs, Lord, I rebuke that spirit, Lord. Everything, Lord, everything. Look down on our pastor and first lady, Lord. You know what they need. You know what each and every one of them need. You know what she needs. You know what he needs. You know what their children need. Save all our children, Lord. We're asking you to save our children, our grandchildren, our great-grandchildren. Oh, Lord, just save them. Save them. Save them from this wicked world out there, Lord. Look down on Elder Barker today, Lord. Look down on him. Look down on him. Touch the man of God, Lord. Touch him in his mind. Lord, touch him in his mind, Lord, touch him in his mind and his spirit, Lord. Just touch that man today in the name of Jesus. He needs you, Lord. He's been serving you a mighty long time, Lord. Touch Elder Barker, Lord. Just look down on each and every one. And Father God, I ask you to look down on the Burnetts with a special blessing, Lord. Bless them in a special way, Lord. Their children, their grandchildren, their unsaved children, Lord. I know they want their children saved. Save them, Lord. Save them, save them, save them. Lord, those that are doing right, but they not saved, save them anyway, Lord. You have that power, Lord. I just thank you for your power, Lord, your wonder-working power. I thank you for salvation today. I thank you for the Holy Ghost, Lord. I thank you for filling me and anointing me to do your will, Lord. And I just ask you to watch over each and every one of us today, Lord, in spirit and in truth. We will serve you, Lord. We will abide in you. We will do your will today, Lord. We surrender, 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 surrender.
Yes, Lord. Today. Hallelujah.
All thanks, Lord. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Glory. Glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Yes. Oh, God, oh, God. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 Hallel
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
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 Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Bring it in my soul. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes, to your will, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory, glory, glory. Thank you. Come on, Minister Keys. Hallelujah. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. God, we thank you today. 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 God, we say thank you. We say thank you, God. Lord, if we had a billion tongues, we could never praise you, magnify you enough, God. Lord, if we live forever and ever, God, we can never praise and magnify you enough, God. We say thank you, God, while we have this chance, God, while you allowed us to have this opportunity, God, to come before your presence, God, to say yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Yes. Yes, Lord, 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 yes, Lord. God, we say yes to you. We say yes, God. We say yes, Lord. We give up everything. We say yes, God. We lay it down. We give up it all, God. We say yes, Lord. We say yes to your will, God. We say yes to your way, God. We say yes to you, God. We say yes to you, God. Yes to your plan for our life, God. Yes to what you have us to do, God. We say yes today, God. We say yes, God. Yes, Lord. Our answer is yes. Our answer is yes. Our answer is yes today. Our answer is yes, God. Lord, in the name of Jesus, God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we're not going to hold back anymore, God. We're going to say yes, God. We say we're not going to forsake, God, what you're giving us to do, God. We're going to say yes, God. We're saying yes right now. Yes down on the inside, God. Yes in our hearts, God. Yes in our minds today, God. We give up all for you, God. Have your way in us today, God. Have your way in us today. Have your way in us, God. We need your way, God. We need you, God, to have your way, God. In the name of Jesus, we're more than conquerors. We're more than conquerors, God. For you said you loved us. You loved us, God. In spite of it all, God, you loved us. You died for us. You gave your only begotten son to die for us. Lord, we say thank you right now. We thank you for your son, God. Your son that died on that cross. Lord, in the name of Jesus, while we were yet sinners, you died for us. You gave up your life for the sins of the world. Lord, we thank you right now. We thank you for your life. Life everlasting that you've given unto us. We your people, God. Have your way in us. Have your way right now. We beseech you now by the mercies of God. Lord, you said if we present ourselves before you, Lord, you said you will deliver us. You said you will forgive us. Lord, you said you will cleanse us. Lord, you said you will strengthen us. Lord, you said you will heal us. Lord, you said you will be with us right now. You said it right now. It is so. It is so. It is so. Your word is a lamp unto our feet and a light unto our path. Lord, we thank you for your God in the way. You are the way. You're the way of escape. You're the way out right now. You are the way right now. We have you in our life. Lord, have your way in us. For you the way, the truth, and the life. In the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you now for that way right now. That way of holiness right now. In the name of Jesus, Lord, we need you to strengthen your people. Everywhere, Lord, you know what they're going through. You know what they're dealing with. We pray on their behalf. They don't know what to pray. Lord, we don't know what to pray either. But you said the Spirit make it intercession for us with groanings that cannot be uttered. In the name of Jesus, when you pray, the devil can't understand. The devil can't comprehend. But when you pray, we get the benefit. We get the benefit of your prayers. In the name of Jesus, we thank you for your prayers right now for our behalf, Father. Lord, we pray now that you have your way in all the earth. They need you. You know what they're going through. Deliver right now. touch right now in the name of Jesus. Lord, lay your hands everywhere. Go into the hospital rooms. Lord, you know the sick and the set in. Lord, deliver them. Many are the afflictions of the righteous. But Lord, you said you would deliver us out of them all. Lord, deliver us right now by your tender mercies, by your grace, which is sufficient for us right now. In the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you. We say thank you for what's already done. We thank you. We thank you now in advance, for we know all things work together for the good. That them that love you, we love you. We love you with our whole heart. We love you with our own mind. We love you in all that we do. We got to show that we love you, because you love that's greater. You love that's first. In the name of Jesus and those that are called according to your purpose, we thank you for your purpose today. Your purpose right now, that we have everlasting life, that we have health, and we have strength. We be prosper, even as our soul prosper right now in the name of Jesus. Lift us up, lift us up in spite of everything that we're going through. We need you right now in the name of Jesus. And we pray those that lost loved ones, lay your hands upon those families now. Lord, strengthen them, heal them, encourage them, lift them up in the name of Jesus. We pray for our leaders. We pray for their continued strength. Lead and guide them everywhere. Our bishops, our pastors, your man and woman servants. Lord, touch them. Touch them like only you can. Have your way in them now. Bless our speaker on today, God. Give her a word from you, God. Encourage our hearts today. Bless her right now for her faithfulness. Protect her, God, as she goes to and fro, God, helping your people. Touch her now. We pray now in Jesus' name. Thank God. Amen and amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Glory to your name.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Thank
Mother
you,
Henry,
Jesus.
Are you available to pray? Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Go ahead, Mother Henry. Hallelujah.
Good morning. Good morning. Good morning.
Hallelujah.
I would like to read this to everybody online today.
Yes, Lord.
I am your Father, God. Yes. Listen to me. Learn what it means to be a child of the everlasting King. Your richest duty is devoted to me. This duty is such a joyful privilege that it feels like a luxury. You tend to feel guilty about pushing back the boundary of your life to make a space for time alone with me. The world is waiting to squeeze you into its mold and to crown out time devoted to me. The way of the world have also warped your conscience, which punish you for doing the very thing that pleased me most. Seek my face. Listen to me above the clarity of voices trying to distract you. Ask my spirit to control your mind, for he and I work in perfect harmony. Be still and attend in my presence. You are on holy ground. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulder, and he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Isaiah 9:6. Rejoice greatly, O daughter of Zion. Shout, O daughter of Jerusalem, behold, your king is coming to you. He is just and having salvation, lowly and riding on a donkey, a colt, the foal of a donkey. Zechariah 9:9. For you did not receive a spirit that make you a slave again to fear, but you received the spirit of sonship. And by him we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit himself testify with our spirit that we are God's children. Romans 8:15-16. Do not come any closer, God said. Take off your sandals, for the place where you are standing is holy ground. Exodus 3:5. Amen.
Oh, yeah. Amen. Praise God. Thank you, Mother Henry. Is that Jesus calling?
Yes, it is.
Amen. Oh, okay. Amen. God bless you. God bless you. Did you want to pray, or that was all you wanted to do?
Let me say a few words. Father God, in the matchless name of Jesus, I thank you, Lord, and I give you praise and I give you glory. Ah, God, you've been so good, so kind, and so merciful. God, we said thank you today. Ah, God, this is a day that you have made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Oh, bless your name. Oh, you're such a good God. You're a mighty God. You watched over us all night long while we slumbered and slept. Lord, you look high and you look low. And God, you couldn't find nobody. Here you go. Thank you, Jesus. But your darling son, Jesus, he came, hallelujah, and he died on the cross for our sins. And we say thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Oh, God, if it ever was a time for us to call on you, this is the time. And we call it on you, Jesus, hallelujah. You're the only one that can help us in this time. And we just say thank you today. We praise your name, God. Oh, you're holy God. You almighty God, you righteous God. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, God, we thank you today. Thank you for wisdom. Thank you for knowledge. And I thank you, I thank you, I thank you for our pastor, Lord God. Continue to give him wisdom, wisdom from on high, wisdom that surpasses all understanding. And God, help him to have the kind of wisdom when he can excel among everyone in his peer. Oh, God, in the name of Jesus, we just thank God, thank God, thank God for the prayer line. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for the conductors. Thank you. Hallelujah. Thank you for all the people of God. In the name of Jesus. God, keep us covered under your wings, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Oh, God, you say you keep those that want to be kept, and we want to be kept by you, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. We just say thank you today. Thank God, thank God, thank God, thank God. God is doing a great thing. Whoa, thank you, Jesus. He's doing great things, saints. Yes. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Oh, such a great thing. He's a great God. He's a mighty God. He's a God that never lost a case. Oh, thank you, Jesus. I just said thank you today. Oh, God. Thank you, Jesus. Yes. Continue to pray for my husband. He thought he was going to get out today, but he's not getting out. The doctor says, a little while longer.
Yes.
He's doing good.
And praise God. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, amen. Praise God. Thank God for that praise report. Amen. Hallelujah. And that prayer from Mother Henry.
Amen.
God bless you. Hallelujah. Amen. This week, we are praying. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. The Lord laid on my heart on Friday. Amen. For this week, we're praying for caregivers. Yes, amen. Lord. Caregivers on this week, especially focusing on the ones that's taking care of their parent or their spouse and their child. I meant to put that in the e-blast, but their child as well. Mm-hmm. Amen. That's what we're praying for. Amen. On this week. So if you know any caregivers, man, please give them the link for our prayer line, mm-hmm. and let them know we're praying for them. Amen. Mm-hmm. Amen. Because we have so many in our church and so many of our families that are taking care of a loved one. Yes. And we definitely want to keep them lifted because it is not an easy job. I did it for me and my husband. He helped me. And my daughter and son helped me take care of my mother for the last month of her life. Didn't know it would be the last month of her life. But we just thank God. It wasn't that easy. Amen. It got harder and harder as the days went by. But I wouldn't trade it for anything in the world to be able to take care of my mother.
Yeah.
Amen. In the last days of her life. Hallelujah. Yeah. Amen. And God allowed that. And I thank God I was able to do it and had the room. And was able to, and I thank God for my husband who was there for me and with me. Amen. So we are praying for you because it's not easy. And at this time, we're going to have our own missionary, Edmondson, who took care of Deacon Edmondson,
yeah.
A prayer warrior. Amen. Yeah. And we're going to ask for her. Amen. The Lord laid her on my heart this morning. Amen, to ask her to give us wisdom, words of encouragement and words of wisdom and words of inspiration. Amen, and how she does it and how she did it. Amen. But she's still doing it today, taking care of seniors. Amen. At this time, we're going to ask that you would unmute yourself and let's give her a hand and let's give God some praise for her. Amen. At this time, hallelujah. Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. She is a faithful woman of God. She is our head missionary at the church.
Amen.
So we want to just keep her in prayer as she continues to work as a caregiver at her job. Amen. Praise God. Missionary Edmondson.
Praise God. I greet each and every one of you in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you for waking me up this morning, closing me in my right mind. You know, just thank him for health and strength, all the activity of my limbs. Today I give him glory and I give him honor and I give him praise. And I just want to, just a few scripture here. It's from Romans 8. God is so good. I think because I heard Brother Minister Keys praying the same thing I got to read. So I know God is doing something. It's Romans 8, starting at the 26 through 28. It says, likewise, the Spirit also helpeth our infirmities. For we know not what we should pray for as we ought. But the Spirit itself maketh intercession for us with groanings which cannot be uttered. And he that searcheth the heart knoweth what is the mind of the Spirit. Because he maketh intercession for the saints according to the will of God. And we know that all things work together for good to them that love God, to them who are the called according to his purpose. Saints, I'm telling you, being a caregiver, it's you have to have a heart. I'm telling you, if it's not for you, go along, don't stop. Because you have to have a heart, not only for your family, but also for others that are in need of care. And you know the heart you have to have like a godly heart, a patient heart, a loving heart, because sometimes things is gonna come up where, man, you gotta have Jesus inside of you. You know, some things might be said or some things might be done, but you know, I wouldn't trade this for anything. Because there's joy in taking care of somebody. There's joy hearing somebody tell you, I don't know what I'll do without you. God bless you. You came the right time. You know, there is just joy in just hearing that. No amount of money could bless you. Like when somebody just look at you and tell you, man, I thank you for doing that, you know. And so today, I just want to encourage each and every caregiver. Whether you work in a dementia unit, assisted living, a nursing home, if it's your calling to be a caregiver, do it with everything that is in you. Pray, seek God, and do it. Do it with a willing heart. Do it with love. Do it with patience. Because what I do sometimes, yeah, it might be rough sometimes, and little funny things they might say, but you know what I do? I turn it into positive things. I would just go in there and just laugh about it. Just this Saturday, I lost a patient of mine. He's 102. He's a pastor. And there are days I would go in there and I'll just pick his brain, even though he has dementia. And I would just say to him, has the Lord been good to you? And he would just wake up. And he said, he sure did. You know, just for that second, he knew who he was. And, you know, it just gives you pleasure knowing that. I would put my phone on the gospel station. God is so good. I'm so fortunate that in the evening, I'm the supervisor. So I had my phone on the gospel station. I'd walk with it in my pocket. So wherever department I go, I would play that gospel music. And sometimes when it seems like they are hungry or just agitated, I would just took my phone out and I would just play a song and it would just calm that situation. So that's why I'm trying to let you saints know, if you are a caregiver, do it to the best of your ability. Do it to the best you know how. Take care of your family. And if you can't, it's not bad to ask for help. Don't be ashamed to ask for help. And if you have to put them in an institution, you search and you look for the best institution that you can put them in. And you don't just leave them there. You go and you visit them. You talk with the workers. You talk with the supervisor, you know, and you visit them. Because, and it's worse if you are a child of God. You commit yourself to the caring of someone that can no longer cares for themselves. So as long as you commit yourself to caring for them, you have to do the best you can. You can't abuse them. You can't talk to them anyhow. You know, it was hard. I did 2 years with Brother Henry. I changed so many hours. I went from 6 a.m. to 2 p.m. Then I went on the night shift. I just changed the days that I would be able to take care of him. Because I really didn't want, that was my decision. I didn't want to put him in a nursing home. I had him there for a couple of weeks, rehabilitation. And the first week I took him out because the condition wasn't right and they weren't treating him good. And that was my decision. And I took him out and I changed my job. I changed so many hours till finally I said, you know, I got to give it up. And so I gave up my job for 2 years. I gave up my job. And even when he was in the hospital and they told me there's nothing they can do and, you know, he's going to be a burden to me and I'm not able to take care of him. I said, no, you're not. I said, I'm taking him home. And, you know, they fight me against it. I didn't say much about it, but I just pray about it. They fight me about it. They call the social service. They call everyone you could think of on me because I decided to take him home. And so they called my doctor. He'd been his doctor for over 10 years. He said, what does his wife say? She wants to take him home. He said, give him to his wife. And I had to make decision. I rearranged my living room. I make it half of it into a bedroom to accommodate him. You know, and I quit my job. I told him, my husband is very sick. And I promised him that if he ever gets sick, I would take care of him. Because he took very good care of me. He never had me wanted for anything. Anything I needed, I got it. And so it was my pleasure to take care of him. There were days when he didn't even know me. He remembered the kids, but he don't remember me. Who am I? I don't know you. And so I didn't take it as an insult. We laughed about it. And the next day he would come back and he would say, hey, you my wife. And I say, yeah, you remember me today? And you say, yeah, I do. But, you know, during all that, I'm just saying that, you know, if you are able and capable of taking care of your loved ones, do it with a willing heart. Do it with love. I didn't have a sad moment. I cried more when he was alive than when he passed away. And the reason why I cry so much, it's just that I didn't want to see him in the condition he was in. And so that's the reason why I wouldn't cry in front of him, because he would ask me, why are you crying? Because he told me, you know, he said his life is in God's hand. And, you know, he said, he's ready. He said, don't worry about it. And the best thing that ever happened was a couple days before he passed away, he wasn't eating or drinking anything, not even talking. And the nurse came to see him. And he said, Mr. Hedmanson, you have a good wife. And he opened his eyes and he looked at me. And he said, yes, I know. And he said, thank you. Thank you so much for taking care of me. Thank you. He never said another word after that. And so just that thank you, knowing that he thanked me, was enough to keep me going on. So saints, don't be weary in well doing. Like the scripture says, the Spirit helps our infirmities. Yeah, we have all those questions, and we have all, sometimes we get upset, or we get mad, or we say things we're not able to say. Talk to the Lord Jesus. He will help your infirmity, whatever it is. Even if the person didn't treat you right, and that person is sick, and he's a loved one, and you are called by the name of Jesus Christ, washed in his blood, baptized, you need to find it in your heart so you can go back to that person and do whatever you can do. If it's even to visit, give a bath, just some encouraging words. Because God, he helps us with our infirmities. Yes, we don't know how to pray, but God, he teaches us how to pray. He shows us how to pray. Because he searched the heart. He searches the heart because he maketh intercession for the saints according to the will of God. So he's making intercession for us. He's pleading for us. He's covering us. Where I'm working, he's covering. I know he's covering that building. I know he's covering it because God knows those people. They are 100, they're 90s. He's covering that building. And you know, when I go there, you know, I told my caregivers, I'm like, if you're not in here to take care of these people, might as well you don't come, because this is what they are here for. They can do it for themselves. They are doctors, they are nurses, they are lawyers. They once were, but they reach a stage where they aren't able to take care of themselves. So if you are called and you can do it, do it. Do it. And if not, just pray with somebody. Just lift up somebody who is able to you know, to take care of that person. Because do all that needs to be done. Give the Lord the freedom to ask for help. And like I said, if you need to place them in a nursing home, that brings more comfort. And it's a heartbreaking decision. You go to the Lord in prayer. You go to the Lord in prayer and you ask him to help you. And today, you know, caregivers, don't give up. It's a special talent. Don't you know how rewarding it is when somebody's call me and they be saying, 102 doesn't want to take a shower. I said, okay. And you go on in and you said, hi, how you doing? Have you eaten your lunch? Everything's going on. I think your clothes need to change. Can I? And right away, and you give that person that shower, and he look at you and say, man, I thank you. I really needed that. You know how rewarding that is? How rewarding it is to sit and help to feed somebody who is not able to feed themselves and watch them eat all the dinner. You know, it's a rewarding thing, but it's not for everybody. It's not for the faint of heart. I'm telling you, it's not for the faint of heart. It needs much prayer. You got to be saved, sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost from head to foot. You know, you got to be covered, completely covered under the blood of Jesus. So today I'm just encouraging all the care workers, those who work in the hospital, those who work in the office, those who have to give treatment, you know, those who have to be with somebody who is sick and need your help, please. Don't be angry. Don't be mean. Treat them with respect. Treat them with kind words. Even sometimes they come in, they be mean and miserable and don't say what they said. But you, with your kind words, you can turn that situation around. You don't have to be mean. You don't have to answer back to what they say. You, with a kind words, you can turn that situation around and that person will come to you and thank you. And even apologize to you. So saints of the Most High, let us recognize who we are and whose we are. And even on the job, let us not be slack. Let us not forget who we are. And if you are there for a reason, do it good. Do it to all your ability, to the best of your ability, and do it to the honor and the glory of God. Because he is the one that's going to be our judge. And he sees and he knows everything. May God bless you, and you have a blessed day in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Come on, let's unmute ourselves. Amen. And let's give
amen.
Our hand.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. Thank you, Missionary Edmondson.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you,
Lord. Words and inspiring words.
God bless you.
How to take care of a loved one or in the facility. Amen. Amen. Because like she said, you have to be saved and sanctified, be with the Holy Ghost from head to toe to be able to take care of someone. Amen. That can't take care of themselves or make decisions for those people. Amen.
Yes.
And we want to continue to pray for y'all all this week during the prayer. Amen. We're praying for caregivers, especially the ones that have to take care of a spouse, a parent, or a child.
Yes.
Amen. Because that's closer to your heart when you have to take care of a loved one.
Yeah.
Amen. So we just want to continue to pray for you because it's not an easy task. It's not an easy job. And we know that on Wednesday, amen, Missionary Brig Maiden, who takes care of her daughter, Raquel, and we've been praying for her for months.
Yeah.
Amen. She will be our speaker on Wednesday for 12 noon. And to encourage someone and inspire someone and give inspirational words and to let us know what how she's dealing with it. Amen. Yeah. We just thank you, Missionary Edmondson, again. Amen. I know it was last notice, but I knew you had a word. Amen. Praise God. And we want to remember that. Romans 8 and 26. Amen.
Yeah.
Praise God. Amen. We're going to turn to the hands of our president. Amen. My husband, the newly ordained Deacon Burnett. Amen. And continue to pray for us.
Yeah.
God bless you. Hallelujah.
Both giving glory and honor to God, the pastor and first lady in their absence. I just thank everyone once again for your support. I know I always say I appreciate everyone's support on this prayer ministry, but you guys just don't know how much it means to me and my wife, you know, for you guys to support us like you do. We are so thankful and so blessed. You know, I just wanted to share this scripture in Galatians 6, 1 and 2. It's one of my favorite scriptures. It says, brethren, if a man be overtaken in a fault, ye which are spiritual, restore such a one in the spirit of meekness, considering thyself, lest thou also be tempted. Bear ye one another's burdens, and so fulfill the law of Christ. You know, sometimes a lot of people that are not on this prayer line that we don't see in our weekly meetings, you know, they're suffering right now. They're really having a hard time of not being able to go to the church. It were people that was on the fence rather than people that were just, you know, getting saved and were just starting to rededicate their lives back to Christ, even the backsliders. You know, so many people are struggling, you know, right now. They may not say anything to you, but they're going through it. And like I said, we should bear one another's burdens, you know. Even if, when it comes to people needing help, we should be there with love and kindness.
Yes.
Like Missionary Edmund said, even if they say something mean to you, you know, we should still be willing to show love and kindness. Love conquers all things.
Amen.
We don't return evil for evil to nobody, you know, and we're here to bear one another's burdens, to lift one another up, to continue to pray and intercede on behalf of the saints. You know, we see I see everybody that's on this prayer line, but there's so many members of ours that's in Solid Rock that's never on the prayer line, that need our prayers, that need our encouragement. You know, and we got to continue to reach out to people. You know, if we can text somebody, call somebody, just try to encourage somebody, you know, that you don't see, that you don't hear from, just to encourage them to come back to God, to join in on the prayer line, to join in on Bible studies, join in on Sunday school. Whatever we can do to encourage somebody, we should be trying to do that. You know, I get encouragement from you guys, like I say, when I see all the support we get and the prayer when people are praying for me. It encourages me, you know, because I can get discouraged just like the next person. You know, life has its challenges and stuff. You know, things ain't always so good. But I just thank everyone for their love and their support. Continue to pray for me and my wife. Continue to pray for one another. And if you can reach out to somebody to encourage them to get on this prayer line, please do it. And I just thank you guys. Continue to pray for us.